स्टेनो वाले बाबू वेलकम्स यू। शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस इन मेल एंड फीमेल वॉइस फ्रॉम ऑल सोर्सेस लाइक मैगजीन्स, स्पीचेस एंड एडिटोरियल्स एट वेरियस स्पीड्स अप टू 120 WPM फॉर वेरियस डिपार्टमेंट्स लाइक SSC, DSSB, CRPF, दिल्ली पुलिस एक्सेट्रा। प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। थैंक यू। एक्सरसाइज नंबर 14। एज आर चेयरमैन रिमाइंडेड यू, आर नेबर्स आर ऑल द कंट्रीज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड नाउ, सो दैट वी कैन नॉट रिलेट आर फॉरेन पॉलिसी जस्ट टू अ फ्यू कंट्रीज around us, but have to think of practically every country in the world and take into consideration all the possible areas of conflict, trade, economic interest, etc. It has been recognized now that if there is a conflict on a big scale anywhere in the world, it is apt to spread all over the world. That is, war has become indivisible and therefore peace is indivisible. Therefore, our foreign policy cannot limit itself to the nearby countries. Nevertheless, the nearby countries always have a special interest in one another, and India must inevitably think in terms of her relations with the countries bordering her by land and sea. What are these countries? If you start from the last, Pakistan, I would also include Afghanistan, although it does not touch India's borders, Tibet and China, Nepal, Burma, Indonesia and Ceylon. In regard to Pakistan, the position has been a very peculiar one owing to the way Pakistan was formed and India was divided. And there have been not only all the upsets that you all know, but something much deeper, and that is a complete emotional upset of all the people in India and Pakistan. Because of this, it is a very difficult thing to deal with, a psychological thing which cannot be dealt with superficially. A year and a half or more has passed, and there is no doubt at all that our relations have improved and are improving. There is also no doubt at all in my mind that it is inevitable for India and Pakistan to have close relations sometime or other in the future. I cannot state when this will take place, but situated as we are with all our past, we cannot really be just indifferent neighbors. We can be either hostile to each other or very friendly to each other. Ultimately, we can only be really very friendly, whatever period of hostility may intervene in between, because our interests are so closely interlinked. As far as the other countries are concerned, our relations with others are quite friendly. Take for instance Afghanistan, and our relations with Afghanistan are exceedingly friendly.
एंड आर रिलेशंस विथ तिब्बत नेपाल एंड ऑल द नेबरिंग कंट्रीज आर ऑल्सो वेरी फ्रेंडली. इफ आर नेबरिंग कंट्रीज हैव इन अ सेंस द फर्स्ट प्लेस इन आर माइंड्स देन द सेकेंड प्लेस गोज टू द अदर कंट्रीज ऑफ एशिया विथ हुम वी आर ऑल्सो फेयरली इंटीमेटली कनेक्टेड. नाउ इंडिया इज वेरी क्यूरियसली प्लेस्ड इन एशिया एंड हर हिस्ट्री हैज बीन गवर्न्ड अ ग्रेट डील बाय द जियोग्राफिकल फैक्टर प्लस अदर फैक्टर्स. विच एवर प्रॉब्लम इन एशिया यू मे टेक अप समहाउ और अदर इंडिया बिकम्स इन टू द पिक्चर. Whether you think in terms of China or the Middle East or Southeast Asia, India immediately comes into the picture. It is so situated that because of past history, tradition, etc., in regard to any major problem of a country or a group of countries of Asia, India has to be considered whether it is a problem of defense or trade or industry or economic policy. India cannot be ignored. She cannot be ignored because, as I said, her geographical position is a compelling reason. She cannot be ignored also because of her actual or potential power and resources. Therefore, whatever our own views may be, by virtue of her practical position and other reason, India is bound to play an important part in Asia, whether it is Western Asia or the Far East to Southeast Asia. It is so happens, of course, that even culturally speaking, our bonds are very great with all these parts of Asia, whether it is Western Asia, of the Far East or Southeast Asia, and these bonds are very old and very persistent. A very curious thing happened when, roughly speaking, British power came to India and British dominion was established here. This was the reason why we were cut off from our neighboring countries of Asia. Our contacts were then with England across the seas, and while to some extent we struggled against that domination and resented those contacts, nevertheless they were there. And we saw the world more and more through that window. The British window, very few people went to the other Asian countries from India, and very few came here from there. And even those few people from Asia we met in Europe and not in Asia. Now, in recent years, that process has been reversed or is being reversed for a variety of reasons. Initially, I suppose the one major factor was air travel. Air travel brought us immediately into close contact with our neighbors, because if we went to Europe, we passed through Baghdad and Tehran and other places. Air travel is not only the factor, there are also political reasons that are now bringing about these changes for future development. Thank you.